economy, the federal government spending cuts hitting jobs here in Central Florida. Dozens of workers at Cape Canaveral Air Force Station will be laid off. WESH 2 Stephanie Culp is live tonight out on the Space Coast. And Stephanie, many of these government employees will be let go tomorrow.
We're talking about federally contracted workers that work here at the Cape Canaveral Air Station. They work on rockets like Atlas and SpaceX. And tomorrow, some of them could be out of a job.
And liftoff of the Atlas V rocket with Tedris Kay.
The men and women who help send our country's rockets soaring through the sky could lose their jobs.
Between 60 and 80 workers totally out there for me, but it could be in the neighborhood of a couple hundred.
Kevin Smith is the union president of Local 525. He represents about 600 workers at Cape Canaveral Air Station. He expects 10% of those workers will see pink slips as soon as tomorrow.
The workers that are going to be laid off are extremely skilled, and they run from almost every classification you can think of. There's mechanics and electricians. There are people that take care of facilities that house specific type of spacecraft.
There are going to be families and communities that are hurt.
The cuts are the result of the sequester, massive budget cuts handed down from Washington.
It will slow some things down and projects won't get finished.
And Smith says these cuts are especially hurtful, not only for the space program, but for all of Brevard County.
We haven't even finished getting over the fact that the shuttle program has been away for a little while, and the county is still feeling the effects of that. And now we're thrown into another situation where on the other side of the river, on the unmanned space side, now we're seeing the same kind of cuts.
And the federal government is notifying the companies that contract the workers that they hope to have the jobs reinstated by September or October. In Brevard County, Stephanie Culp, WESH 2 News.